Okay, let's go to Limbe now in camera. Our correspondent Cecilia Mwagwe is with the team. Good morning, Cecilia. Welcome to the show.
Good morning, Austin. Good morning, Jack.
Good morning. Okay.
Yeah, Cecilia, D-Day for the Super Falcons. We're talking about it here. What's the mood like in the camp of the Super Falcons?
Yeah, definitely. It's a big day. And all of them, you can see yesterday, I had like 2-3 players that were with me who wanted to talk on the show. But today, all of them said they are fully focused. They're not ready to come out. They're having their breakfast this morning. And after that, they'll do a light workout. And after that, they'll definitely be ready for the match tonight. The mood in camp is generally okay, generally cool. You know, everywhere there's this negative feeling about the Super Falcons because they haven't had the abundances, you know, and everything. But the girls are saying, look, we're not focused on that. We came here to reclaim the title, and that's what we are going to do. That's the good thing about them. None of them is concerned about what's happening around them. But the big focus is the game against South Africa. And looking at the South Africans, I mean, all of us were actually surprised when their last game, they scored 5. And I asked most of the players, look, you have different 5 players scoring against Egypt. What are you girls going to do? And the big question was like, okay, South Africa, come on, 5 players, whatever we can do, we definitely want to do it. We don't care about whatever antics they're going to put up against us. But all we need to do is to just go out there knowing that we're fully focused. And the big target is even retaining the title. So they're looking beyond the semi-final. This is more like, okay, a game, fine, in South Africa. And you remember in 2012 what happened, you know, when South Africa defeated Nigeria. It said that was just a one-off. But this time around, the girls are fully focused and they just want to go ahead and retain that title. And talking about the South Africans, I spoke with some of their players yesterday. I mean, they were like, okay, we know that 85% of the Nigerian girls are playing abroad. We're not concerned about that. We know Asisat Oshoala can actually hold on to her. We should be able to do something spectacular. And I asked them, do you know about Zaya Paranozie, Francesca Odega? Anybody can actually score from that squad. They were not concerned. But all of them are actually focused on Asisat, which is pretty good for Nigeria, because if you want to hold on to Asisat, you have other players who can actually, you know, do the damage and do a very good job.
Okay, Cecilia, yesterday we saw a couple of players sit out, you know, the training session. Yeah. You said precautionary reasons. I mean, what's the status for today's game?
Yeah, they're very, very okay. Because even yesterday morning, while I was talking to you guys in the morning, Onomeya Biu had the POP around her neck. She has already removed these, and she even trained yesterday. So all the players trained yesterday. Ugoku, Asisat Oshoala, everybody, they all trained yesterday. So it shows that all of them, they're ready. So it was just a little knock, the pick here and there. And the coach said, okay, you girls can actually sit. They actually wanted to train, but she insisted and said, no, don't worry, just take care. This is the first training after the game against Kenya. Just hold on. And they did. And at the end of the day, yesterday, they all trained. So right now, all the 21 players we have in camp, they are good to go.
Cecilia, before we let you go, you're right there with the team. You've seen them train. You know the mood. Give us a prediction, Nigeria, South Africa.
I think it's going to be tough because the South African girls are talking tough, even the coach. You know, they said they want to shock Nigeria. But for Nigerians, I think with the kind of mood I've seen, and we've seen them in training, I expect maybe 3-1 or 2-1. I think I expect something good from our girls. It's going to be a victory, no more, no less, because the target is even looking beyond this right now. We saw the South Africans' preparations because they are looking at the fact that Nigeria didn't really prepare well for this tournament. That's what they're looking at. We saw the fact that they went to the Olympics, and for the Olympics, they played Netherlands, USA, New Zealand, and all kinds of country. And even after that, when they came out from the Olympics, they played Egypt, they played Zimbabwe, they played about 2-3 friendlies before they came to Cameroon. So they're thinking they have that edge. And they're thinking they have, like, how many coaching crew that came with them? Like 11. If you see the South African contingent, you'll be wondering, is it just this tournament, or you have other, I know some of those coaches going for other tournament. You have fitness trainer, office, a gym, one taking charge of their gym, one, two, nutritionist, everybody, like 11, 12. I was able to count, you know, yesterday when I met with the team. So it's like they are fully, really ready for this game. So Nigeria know, they know what they can do to actually get something out of it. I think we can nick this one. We just can't do this.
Okay. Thank you so much, Cecilia, for that update. And thank you too for breaking my heart with that South African update. But it's okay. Thank you, Cecilia. I will talk to you again tomorrow.